Okay, so we're going to do a little crush and strain today. So here we go. We've got some comb honey on the left and comb honey on the right, and one is light and one is dark. Here is a shot of the dark one. And if you look at this, you're thinking, oh yeah, that looks like dark honey. And then if you look at this one, you think, oh yeah, this is going to be light honey. It's going to be totally different colored texture, the whole deal. Look, another, here we go. There's some more dark honey. Looks like dark honey. Looks like, hey, this is going to be nice and red or something. And this is going to be yellow, whatever. So here we go. I've got about, okay, now this is basically what I did. I cut the comb out of the frames like this in my kitchen, and I smash them up. And I put them in a bowl, and I smash them up and crush them up with a potato masher. And there's a sample of the light stuff, but I did it with the dark stuff too. And I'm just gonna go back and forth with the light stuff and the dark stuff because this is basically two sessions. I did three or four frames of light stuff and three or four frames of the dark stuff. And I strain them separately. There's a shot of the dark stuff. And you're looking, oh, hey, this has definitely gotta be some nice dark honey coming out of that one, right? Well, we're gonna find out. And there's some of the dark stuff in a bowl, I think. I squished, yeah, so that one got smashed up in a bowl. And this is the dark stuff getting smashed up in the bowl, and then I also smash up the stuff in the in a pot for the yellow stuff. So this is what we call crush and strained honey. You just take the pure, then there it is all smashed up. You take the pure honeycomb or comb honey, smash it up, just break the cell so that the honey can come out of it, and then you strain it. Just put it, use an old kitchen strainer, any kind of strainer will do. The dark honey was in a regular strainer, so not a lot of, so a lot of pollen and little bits of wax came through the strainer, which is fine, totally cool. There's nothing wrong with it. This is the yellow stuff or the lighter stuff, and it was through a more so-called professional strainer. And it filters out most of the pollen, and that's what I did it with. I did it with a knife, a potato masher, and a thingamajig. Anyway, so this is afterwards, and meanwhile, so the honey is straining, and while the honey is straining overnight in a warm room where the honey is nice and anyway, you just warm up the honey and let it all strain. This is what the bees are doing while that's going on. They're cleaning up all that sticky old wax that's left over. And then you can make bombs out of it or whatever you want. I usually just give it away because I can't be bothered. So there we go. The left one there is the dark honey, and the one on the right is the light honey. And it doesn't look any different, does it? And I'll tell you why it doesn't look any different. Because what happened is those bees, this is my theory anyway, that I didn't use a queen excluder this year. I'm getting tired of queen excluders because my bees tend to swarm when I use queen excluders, so I didn't do it. And some of the frames had brood in them initially, and then the queen or the bees backfilled those frames with honey, and it looks darker. It's like putting honey in a clear bottle and honey in a slightly tinted bottle. The stuff in the slightly tinted bottle is going to look darker, but once you smash it up and squish it and do all that fun stuff like I just did here, it's basically the same honey, even though it doesn't look like the same honey when you cut the comb out and start smashing it up. And there you go. Crush and strain honey in my kitchen.